Welcome back to the Lars Larson Show. You know, we all worry about our health, and I worry about mine because I'm getting to be an old man. And my doc, Dr. Brian Burke, is on the phone with me right now. And I got this item the other day, and I was a little concerned about it because Dr. Burke has reassured me that, from times past, that all my blood work and everything else says that, you know, I'm not on the path to prostate cancer right now. But then again, I don't know, Doc, if all of us guys live to be old enough, we're probably all going to get it at some point, right?
Yeah, you got about a 1 in 6 chance of being diagnosed with prostate cancer sometime in a man's lifetime.
So then I read this thing about the omega-3 fatty acids that people are always talking about as a great way to, you know, stave off all kinds of other bad health effects. And this says taking fish oil, which they're, you know, people say you got to take fish oil and keep your health, your heart healthy, may actually increase your chance of getting prostate cancer. What's the deal with that?
Well, this is based on a study that came out in July of this year. And this wasn't a study designed to look to see if fish oil consumption increases the risk or decreases the risk of prostate cancer. This was actually a data set from a previous study that a group of researchers got, and they retested the blood sample from this and then extracted data from that to try to reach this conclusion.
So in other words, they were doing one kind of study, but because they got a bunch of information, they were able to kind of pull out some of the data and say it appears to show that if you take the fish oil to keep your heart healthy, other things are going to go wrong.
Yeah, this was actually a study designed to see if selenium and vitamin E would lower risk of prostate cancer. They actually found that vitamin E increased the risk for prostate cancer.
What?
Which was a little surprising to them. But vitamin E is not proven to be the panacea that a lot of people thought it was going to be initially.
This is why I'm always a little bit suspicious of some of the so-called natural cures and everything else. Because when you actually look at the data, something that, you know, probably is good for some things is probably bad for other things. I mean, you and I have had that conversation.
All the time. Absolutely. Yeah. You know, and it seems like every week there's a study that comes out that contradicts something that came out 3 months before. So it sometimes leaves us scratching our heads, and sometimes it's bad research. And but you always have to dig a little deeper into the study itself. So in this particular study, they didn't take any information on whether these men were taking supplements or what their fish consumption was, anything like that.
Yeah.
All right.
Then how did they know that it was the omega-3 fatty acids that were...
What they did when these men enrolled, and this was a national study. It was in Canada, the U.S., Puerto Rico. So they had thousands of participants.
Okay.
So when men entered this study, they had a blood sample drawn. Okay? And that was really the only blood sample that the researchers drew on them. And then years later, when they developed the idea for this study, they went back to those frozen blood samples, and they tested those for fatty acids. They tested those for the omega-3 fatty acids because the omega-3 fatty acids are mainly in our cell walls. So they sort of migrate. They form part of the cell walls of our cells, okay? So they ran tests to look at various types of these omega-3 fatty acids, and then they compared the men with the highest amount of fatty acids and the men with the lowest amount of fatty acids, and then they looked to see whether those men developed prostate cancer during the course of that study.
And it turns out they do, right?
Yeah, they correlated those two. So they said, all right, if you had a high amount of fatty acids in your blood at this one point in time, right? And I want to emphasize that. This was a single blood test. They didn't do serial blood tests. They don't know if a given individual's fatty acid levels would have gone up or down or all around during the course of the study. They don't know after the blood test was drawn whether those men started using a fish oil supplement or stopped their fish oil supplement or started eating fish or became vegetarian. All right? So this was a total snapshot from one point in time. But they found an association where the higher fish oil or omega-3 fatty acid level in the blood was associated with a higher risk of prostate cancer, and particularly the higher grade prostate cancer.
And that's so the more dangerous, the one that's more likely to kill you.
Right. And this same researcher, the lead researcher is a guy out of Fred Hutchinson Cancer Center in Seattle.
Seattle, right?
Yeah. very well-respected research center up there, and he had done a previous study looking at a different data set from a different prostate cancer prevention trial about 4 years before that, and they found something similar there. Now, there was another study, you know, that came out in, I think it was 2007, that found that higher levels of fatty acids of these omega-3s actually decreased the risk of prostate cancer.
So,
of the high-grade prostate cancer.
By the way, I'm talking to Dr. Brian Burke from Sendent Health, who's my doctor, and we call on him when we see these stories in the news. What should we do then? Do we take this stuff or not? Because
What we know about fish oil.
All right.
Fish oil has an anti-inflammatory effect, which is generally a good thing, right?
Okay.
We know it decreases arrhythmias. It decreases triglycerides in the blood and tends to increase the HDL a bit. It even has a little lowering effect on blood pressure. We think it may decrease the aggregation of platelets. So, you know, when our body forms a clot in the wall of the blood vessel, like our coronary arteries, that's what starts the process of a heart attack going. So if you decrease the platelets aggregating and coming together and forming that clot, then that's a good thing. So there's been a lot of research on fish oil, and some of it contradicts others of it. But by and large, we think that it's a beneficial thing. We know that that populations that have higher fish consumption, such as the Japanese, have lower risks for things like prostate cancer and heart disease.
So what's the practical advice now with this, you know, the previous study that says it lowers your chance, the current study that says it raises your chance? You just flip a coin or what?
Well, I think we need more data. I think we need a study that addresses, that actually is looking at fish oil consumption, whether it's from natural fish or from a supplement, probably at varying dosages, and then following that group of men over time and see if they develop prostate cancer.
All right. Now let me bring on a young lady who just called in, and she has a question for you. This is not my Tina. This is somebody else's Tina. Tina, welcome to the program. Just had to make that clear. What's your question or comment for Dr. Burke?
Okay, I have osteoarthritis in my thumb. I believe that the fish oil has some hidden lime in it because it causes my thumbs to just flame on. And another guy who was taking it for his heart, and he's got all of these blood vessels in his chest, you know, going up to his neck, and they were all swollen. They had him on all this medicine. I told him, get off the fish oil, and he got better.
Doc, you referred to it as an anti-inflammatory. Is it possible it does the other?
Well, not for what we know. Now, it's hard to drive down into what's causing an individual's problem.
Right. Because you got too many other
factors.
There's
all sorts of anecdotes out there for any medicine that you want to name or any over-the-counter supplement you want to name. You know, there's some evidence that fish oil and particularly the phospholipid part of fish oil actually reduces inflammation because it's used in a lot of inflammatory conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis and lupus, things like that, and people have had good results from that. Now, that's kind of anecdotal as well. So it's one of those things where your results may vary.
Well, Doc, is there a good resource you can point people to for checking out what they should do in the meantime about omega-3 fatty acids?
Yeah, I like the resources that I go to. I think the Mayo Clinic is a very good source. I think they update that regularly, and that's a good source right there. I think talk to your doctor, and you know, at this point, I mean, I take fish oil myself as a preventative basis. I'm still taking it. I took two capsules this morning.
Well, that's probably the best kind of advice. Dr. Burke, we appreciate you taking the time today.
Always nice to talk to you, Lars.
Dr. Brian Burke from Sendent Health, back in just a moment. You're listening to the Lars Larson Show.